In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Docker container with a Django REST framework application. So before we get started, let's just talk through the dependencies that you're going to need for this project. As you can see, I'm using Linux Mint here. However, you can use Windows, Mac, or Linux, whatever one you choose. The steps will be practically the same, except if you're using Windows, then you'll be using the command prompt instead of the terminal window. Docker is available for all of these platforms, so you can head over to docker.com and download the latest version of Docker for either Mac or Windows. Once you have Docker installed, you're going to want to install a tool called Docker Compose. Now, I've provided links to all of these in the notes of the video, so you can just follow the link and then follow the instructions on the Docker Compose or the Docker website to install Docker Compose. You're also going to need Git because we're going to be cloning an existing project from GitHub. So once you have those things installed, we're good to go. All right, so I've added a link to a project in the notes of this video called the byob-profiles-rest-api project. This project is an application that we create in my course, How to Build a REST API. Now, you don't need to follow the course for this video. You can just go ahead and clone the code. This is the finished code that you would create in the course if you were to take the course. And basically, in the course, I teach how to build a REST API, but I teach using Vagrant. So while we're building our API and testing it, we're using Vagrant. And this video is basically explains how to convert that to a Docker file or how to create a Docker container for the project so you can use that instead of Vagrant. The reason why I chose Vagrant for the course is because Vagrant has a bit of an easier learning curve. It's easier just to get installed and up and running on a machine. But Docker is a little bit more complicated. However, there are a lot of benefits from using Docker. I like how you can just test using the actual Docker container on your local machine that you will be using in the live environment. So let's start by cloning this code. I'm going to copy the link under clone or download, and I'm just going to head over to my terminal, or if you're on a Windows machine, you'll be using your command prompt. And then I have a location here called workspace where I just clone all of my files to all of my projects. I'm just going to type git clone and then the name of the URL for the project. And then once it has downloaded or once it's cloned, I'm going to switch to it using cd command byob, and I'm going to open it in my text editor Atom. You can use Atom or you can use whichever text editor you prefer to use. So once the project loads, the first thing that we want to do is we want to create what's called a Docker file. Now, the Docker file is a file that contains a list of instructions that Docker should follow when creating our image. So Docker has kind of two stages. It has the build stage and the run stage. So on the build stage, you will build your container and it will actually create a container image which you can then run to run your application. So during the build stage, what it does is it looks at the Docker file and then it creates an image and runs all of the commands in the Docker file on the image so that the image is prepared. So that's what it does to build your image. Let's go ahead and create a Docker file by right-clicking the project name and click new file. And you want to type Docker file with a capital D, and there's no file extension. It's just simply a file called Docker file. All right, so once that is created, let's go ahead and create our Docker file. So the Docker file consists of a few different commands that we're going to run to prepare our image. The first one is we're going to tell it what image to base our Docker image off. So one of the cool things about Docker is that you can layer the images on top of each other. So there's a whole marketplace of images available for free that you can use when building your project. And these images all contain kind of, they're like base images that are set up for specific types of application. So for example, we're going to be using a Python base image because our application is a Python image. And it basically just saves us a whole bunch of time because we don't need to go and create and install all the Python dependencies. We just simply type from, with a capital, all caps, and then the name of the image, which is python-3. And this will base our image off a Python image. So at this point in the build phase, we will already have all the dependencies we need for a standard Python project set up. That's Python, pip, the basic Linux OS, all stuff like that. All right, so the next thing we want to do is create an environment variable called Python unbuffered. So let's type that, env, and then all caps, Python unbuffered, and then we'll set that to 1. All this does is it sets the Python output, so the application output when you run it in Python, to unbuffered. So it doesn't buffer it in the std in and out input outputs. It just sends it straight out to the terminal. And this just makes it a little bit easier when we're interacting with the Docker container. All right, next we want to create a directory in our container for our source code. So this is going to hold all of the code for our application. So type run, all caps, and then mkdir/code. The run command, all that does is it allows us to run a command as if we were running it on the server while it's being set up. So we're just running the mkdir command to create a new directory called /code. Next, we're going to set our workdir. So this is the working directory that we're going to use when we're interacting with our Docker container. So type workdir, and then the directory we just created called code. So just type workdir /code. Next, we're going to copy all of the files for our project to our container. So the container at this point is literally just a Python 3 based container. We've set an environment variable and we've created a directory, but the container doesn't actually contain our source code. So we're going to want to copy our source code from our local machine to the image that we're building. The way you do that is you use the copy command. You type copy dot and then /code/. Now the dot just says copy from our local project files. So all of these files here are going to be copied to our /code directory on our container. Finally, we're going to want to run pip install to install the requirements for our project. So our project comes with a requirements.txt file. It's a list of Python requirements that we need for our project. All right, so the way we do that is, again, we use the run command and we just type run pip install -r, says install from a requirements file, and then requirements.txt. The reason we can just type this requirements.txt here is because we're already working in our /code directory. So the focus is on that. And we've copied all of our source code here, including our requirements file, to this location. So since we've copied it there and we're working on that directory, we can just type pip install requirements.txt. All right, so that's all we need for our Docker file. This is a very simple Docker file. If you just save that. Next, we're going to be creating our Docker Compose config. Now, Docker Compose is an optional tool that you can use with Docker just to make it easier to interact with Docker when you're working with it. So it basically is, it's really useful for development environments. It lets you describe multiple different Docker containers and how they should run. And it also lets you do cool stuff like forward the ports and set dependencies between different containers if your application requires multiple containers. Let's go ahead and create a Docker Compose config by right-clicking our project and type in docker-compose.yml. Hit enter on that. All right, so in the Docker Compose, the top line, we need to specify which version of the Docker Compose syntax we're going to be using. We're going to be using the Docker Compose 3 syntax. So you just type version colon and then in quotes the version we want to use. All this is a backward compatibility feature. So if Docker release Docker Compose version 4 in the future, it knows that it should run this based on the version 3 version of the syntax. All right, so now we can define our services in our Docker Compose file. Type services, colon, and the services we want to define are web, and under web, we're going to tell it how to build our container or where the location of our Docker file is. So you just type build, colon, dot. That just says build from our current directory. Next, we want to specify the command that we want to run when we run our container. We type command, colon, python, src, /profiles, project, /manage.py, run server, 0.0.0.0:8000. It's a bit long, that command, but it is quite simple. All it says is use Python to run the manage.py script under src/profiles project/manage.py, which is here. And that's just the Python, the Django management script that allows us to interact with our Python project. And we're gonna call that, and we're gonna pass in the arguments run server and then this location, this IP address. And what this is gonna do is it's just gonna start the development server in our image. Okay, so next we wanna map a volume to our container. So type volumes, colon, hyphen, dot, colon, /code. What this does is it maps a volume from our local location, so the location we run in Docker Compose from, to /code on our project. The reason we do this is this allows us to have real-time access to the code within our Docker file. So it's basically like the synchronized folder in a Vagrant project. Whenever we make a change to our source code here, it will automatically be mapped to our Docker container that will be running. So we can make changes in real time without having to rebuild and run our container each time we make a change. Finally, we're going to map a port from our container to our local machine. Now, the way that we do that, we just type ports, and you can map as many ports as you like, but we just need to map port 8000 to port 8000. Since we're going to be running our development server on port 8000, we just need to map that to our host machine. So when we access port 8000 on our host machine, it will forward the connection to our Docker container so that we can actually access our development server. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can save our file. And the next step is to set up our database for our project. Our project uses a simple SQLite database, and it creates that in the local container that we run it on. So we need to run the migration command in order to migrate our project. The way that we do that is we use Docker Compose to override, we use the Docker Compose run command to override this command here. So what we do is we type, let me just move this so that you can see it, away from my head, type docker-compose, I'll just expand this a bit so you can see it clearly, there you go, Docker Compose run, and then the name of the service we want to run our command on. If you remember, we created a service called web here. I'm going to type docker compose run web, and then the command that we want to run. So we want to run python src/profiles project/manage.py migrate. Hit enter. And what this actually does is it goes ahead and it creates our Docker container for us and then runs the command that we just specified on it. So it automatically builds the container for us when we type that. If you want to manually build the container, you can just type docker-compose build, and this will go and it will build our container for us. You can see that it's following all the steps that we specified. It actually lists all of the steps 1 of 6. So first one is start from the Python 3 container. The next one is set the environment variable, and then it runs the command to create our directory. And then it sets our work dir to /code, and then it copies our source code, and then it installs all the requirements. So that's what it's doing now, is it's installing all of the requirements into our Docker container. So we'll wait for that to finish. It looks like it's on the last stage now. There you go, so it's built our image, and now we can start our image by typing docker-compose-up. Like I said, you don't need to manually build it. If you type docker-compose-up, it will automatically build it for you before it runs it. Okay, so here you can see that our development server is running. If we head over to the browser and we type localhost-8000, it will connect to our container. If I show you this side by side, move this here, you can see just behind my head here that every time you access the server, so we type /API, it outputs here that it's loading all the files. So this is the log output from our Django server. Okay, so that's how you create a Docker file for a Django REST framework project. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. And if you have any questions or you run into any issues, please feel free to leave questions in the comments below. Or if you have any opinions or feedback or whatever about Docker versus Vagrant or using Docker for these types of projects, then please let us know. I'd love to hear about it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time.